The answer to your second question is yes. We are committed to doing everything that we possibly can to slow the spread of this virus so that we protect the integrity of our healthcare system. We understand that no local jurisdiction nor any state jurisdiction have the resources available to ensure that every single person wears a mask no matter what. But I do think that if local officials, and this is the reason I had a call with supervisors yesterday, I had a call with the municipal league yesterday, we do believe that if there's buy-in, not only by state officials, but also buy-in by the local officials, if there's buy-in by law enforcement to wear a mask, we are seeing much greater compliance. I'll tell you anecdotally, we are seeing much better compliance with wearing masks today than we did 5 or 6 days ago, and significantly better than we saw 2 or 3 weeks ago. People are understanding the importance of it. Now, one of the conversations we had today, Dr. Burks has worked all over the world and spent the better part of her career working on HIV and other things in Asia and in Africa. And one of the points that I found striking today is that, you know, when you go to Asia, particularly China and otherwise, in many instances, a lot of those individuals have been wearing masks for years and years and years. And so it's sort of in their culture, wearing a mask is not seen as anything other than somewhat normal. Well, in America, that hadn't been the case, and it certainly isn't the case in Mississippi. And so they had an easier time convincing their general public to wear masks than maybe we have here in America. But we're not going to have enough law enforcement officers to go and arrest people who aren't wearing masks. You're probably not going to get arrested. But that's not just because you're not going to get arrested doesn't mean you ought not do it. And so we are urging all Mississippians to wear a mask in public. You will help us slow the spread if you wear a mask, and if you help us slow the spread, you are going to be helping save lives. There is no doubt about it. I mean, it is very clear that much of where we find ourselves today started by young people who were, in many instances, asymptomatic, spreading it to their moms and their dads, which ultimately got to their grandmoms and granddads. When it gets out in communities, whether we, no matter what we do, it ends up getting into either a healthcare worker or a worker at a long-term care facility, and they take it into the facility. A lot of times, it's not intentional. No one is necessarily doing this on purpose, but it's just the natural flow of what a pandemic looks like, and that's where we find ourselves.